Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to install and use NoScript. This tutorial will show you how to install and use it at a very basic level to block scripts that try to load while you surf online. Now these scripts, some of them could be web ads, malicious, or just overall annoying, and we're going to block them all. First, open Firefox. From there, we're going to open up Google. From here, you're going to type in NoScript, and then you're going to look for https://noscript.net and click that link. After you get to the vendor's website, you'll see the little install button on the left-hand side, and if you feel like being generous, you can donate to support the software. As an FYI, the Firefox extension NoScript is only good for Firefox, SeaMonkey, or other Mozilla-based browsers. It won't work with Chrome, Edge, Safari, or Opera, as of yet, maybe in the future. Now go ahead, click install. When you click install, you'll be brought to the Mozilla add-on window. Here, you're gonna click add to Firefox. You'll get a little permissions notification. Read through them, make sure you're comfortable. NoScript will have to read your data to help you block the scripts from the websites that you're surfing to. So if you're okay with that, click add and begin. NoScript has been added to Firefox. Perfect. When you first add it and you go to your favorite website, you'll start noticing a little icon that looks like an S with a red circle and a slash through it. This is NoScript. It might be on the left or the right hand side. When you first click it, you'll notice all the sites that it blocks. Now by default, NoScript is going to block everything, so don't worry. I'm going to show you how to enable the sites by root domain, and then we can go from there and allow all your favorite sites and keep all the badness blocked. When you first click NoScript and you open up this window, you'll notice there's many domains and you won't know which one is to allow your website to load. Now there are content domains, and then there's the actual domain you're going to. In my case, this is CNN. So when I open up NoScript, the first thing you're going to notice is three dots, CNN and .com. And then you're going to notice chartbeat.com, optimizely.com, and sharethrough.com. Now these three I know are not required for CNN.com. So if I want to allow everything to do with CNN.com, I'm going to come over here and then there's these options. Now the default means it's default block. The second one is temporary trusted, which means that it'll event when you restart your browser, NoScript will put it back to the default of block. Then there's trusted, untrusted, which means it stays blocked even when you restart your browser. And then there's custom, which allows you to specify what you want to block from that domain specifically. We won't go into these details. This is a little bit more advanced than we need to. So for now, if we want to allow just the CNN domain, we're going to come over here and we're going to allow trusted. Now when you click that, just click back to the web page and the page will load. And as you can see, your browser will load the domain and everything to do with CNN. Now because you're blocking all the other scripts that are trying to run, sometimes you'll notice the page will have spaces like this. Those are web ads, or malicious links, or the vendor trying to load something specific that isn't hosted on CNN.com or whichever domain you're trying to go to. If you look through the list, you'll start noticing there's Twitter ads, Amazon, Bing. And if you keep going, you'll start noticing other domains. You'll even notice some that belong to CNN. Now, if you notice anything on the page that doesn't quite look right, or because you allowed the root domain, the web page still isn't loading right, you'll have to go through the list and look for the more domains that belong to the one that you're trying to go to and allow them. If you're unsure, then just pick temp trusted. That way, when you restart the browser, it'll go back to being denied again. You want to configure it even further, there's these options up here. So you can reload, which is the same as clicking into the website after you change an option. You can go to Options, which allows you to configure. There's also Disable Restrictions Globally, which disables all the restrictions with NoScript but doesn't uninstall it. And then that way you can load the page and not be annoyed by all the script blocking. There's Disable Restrictions for this tab, so you can specifically disable the restrictions for the tab. There's Set All on this page to Temporary Trusted. So you can set the entire page to Temporary Trusted. And then you'll notice CNN will start loading all the web ads and any link that had to do with the page. After that, there's Revoke Temporary Permissions. So if you click that by accident or you're not sure of what you just allowed, you can just come here and click Revoke. All your temporary permissions will go away, and the one that you allowed will still be trusted. If you want to configure it even further, you can go to Options. Looks like you'll get a window that looks like this. This is the advanced options of NoScript. Here, you can disable restrictions globally again. Temporary set top level sites to trusted. So here, you can do it what we did in the previous steps where we allowed just the CNN domain. You can allow all top level sites to be trusted. Per site permissions. Here, you can see all the sites that you've whitelisted. And you can change the options for them if you ever feel like something isn't right or you don't want to allow it. Like here we have netflix.com. Maybe you might want to block that and say untrusted so that way Netflix domain never loads. But maybe you might see a web ad domain in here as well. And if you want to block that, you can come into site per site permissions and block. There's also appearance. This is completely up to you. You can display the counts on the badge. Show NoScript contextual menu item. You don't have to show these. You don't have to touch this at all on a basic level. And then there's advanced. My advice is not to touch these unless you read up on it. This is a very good option, but can be very annoying. After you're done in here, if you're ever lost or you need to reset the settings of NoScript, you can just do it right here. They have a reset button. If you go back to general, you'll have the customized changes that you do to default, trusted and untrusted. So you can make by default, you can allow them. So that way any site that's loaded by default it'll allow the scripts, the objects, the media, the frame, the font, the WebGL, fetch, and other. But I would say leave these as is. That way you can get used to it. When you're all done there, you can just close this window. And then you can start going to your favorite sites and you can start allowing the domains that you know. So as you can see here, these are temp trusted, but because I want to trust TD Bank, I'll change them to trusted. And when I click back into the page, it'll reload and things will start loading properly. When I go to the login screen, I'll probably get more blocks. Oh, okay, so because we allowed td.com, the whole domain, it only blocked the web ads. So again, the best thing to do is to go through all the web pages that you know you surf to, especially news sites, go through NoScript, allow the three dots and then domain, which will allow the entire domain that you're trying to go to, and keep everything else blocked. Now you'll notice domains as well that look like this, which are Yahoo's image servers. Sometimes if you block these, you'll notice that some of their images won't display for you. So you'll have to go in and trust those and everything will start working. After you're done that, you're pretty much done. NoScript will block every script that you try to go to on a web page, whether it's malicious or web ad. And you can go through it. You have all the control. And that's pretty much it. Thanks. If you found this video useful, please give it a like, comment below, and consider subscribing for future videos. Thanks, and take care.